Hey guys, welcome back to my channel here. This is Penguin Tech. Today I'm going to bring you a tutorial guide on how to overclock a NVIDIA GeForce card. And so this tutorial will be applicable to all GeForce cards ranging from 9000 series all the way up to the recent RTX 2000 series. So to begin with, you'll need a software to help you to overclock your GPU. So in this case, I would recommend you to use this MSI Afterburner, which I will leave a download link on my video description below. But actually, you can also use other softwares like those provided by EVGA and ASUS, but those are pretty much dedicated to their own GPU lineup. So, but for other brands, the MSI Afterburner can definitely support on the overclock. Okay, so this is the software interface here. As you can see, the GPU right now is sitting at 139 MHz because it's actually not doing anything. And the memory space is actually on 405 MHz, but it's actually like 810. You need to double this for the actual reading. And so I'm on the GeForce GTX 1070, and the driver version is 436.48, which is the latest by the time this video is uploaded. And I'd like to bring you a short intro to my GPU here. So this is my GPU. It is a ASUS ROG STRIX GTX 1070 8GB. It's not the Aussie version, and as you can see here, the spec here, and right now I'm in the gaming mode, which is the default mode by ASUS. I'm not in the Aussie mode yet, but anyway, we will not be using this because we're going to overclock over this. So right now the GPU boost clock is at 1683, but the base clock is only 1506. But in actual fact, when the GeForce GPU boost 3.0 kicks in, it's going to run up to 1823. That's the highest we see. So let me give you an example here. So aside from the overclocking tool that you need, you also need a benchmarking tool to test your GPU stability once it's overclocked. So right now we'll be running a benchmark with the stop clocks here to give you a comparison later on. So the tool I'll be using is the Unijing Heaven Benchmark 4.0. I'll also leave a download description down below. Right now I'm in the extreme preset. So let us just run the test first. So as you can see, we're running the test now. And this is the GPU clock right now. As you can see, it's auto boosted to 1835. When it's only 1683 as stated on the web page here. This is a clear example when the GPU boost 3.0 kicks in, and the fan is sitting at 39% here. And as you can see, the memory is running at 4000 megahertz. When you double it, it's 8000 megahertz here. And as you can see here, the FPS, the min FPS and the max FPS here. So one thing I want to point out is that as you can see here on the right side here, the graphics is reading at 1911 megahertz, but this is not the correct reading. The correct reading is actually only 1823. So I'm not exactly sure why Unijing Heaven Benchmark is reading the wrong reading, and it's much higher than the actual reading here. So as you can see, it's actually fluctuating a bit here, but it's still staying at 1800 and above. So we'll come back later and see the result of the stop clock later on. So we have gotten our result here, and the score, the average FPS is 108.6 and the score is 2735. So we'll now move on to the overclock. But before I overclock, I would like to bring you to your attention that for my GPU, the GTX 1070, this is only a single pin 8-pin GPU. It's not the overclock OC version, which uses 8-pin plus 6-pin. So but you'll see that this GPU can also achieve 200 megahertz clock speed. And to overclock, you just need to use this MSI Afterburner. You just have to adjust your power limit, temperature limit, core clock, and the memory clock. And so the two main things you can adjust is these two, the core clock and memory clock. Let us just try a 200 overclock on the core clock, and 200. And 100 on the memory clock. So you need to click this apply, so that it applies the speed onto your GPU here. And now you can go into and run your benchmark again, and if it crashes, you may have to lower your settings here. So let us run through. If it goes through successfully, we can compare the score here. As you can see now, the quad core is actually hitting over 2000 megahertz, and the memory core has been given a 100 megahertz boots, which when you double it is actually running at 8200, which makes sense. And here you can see that the memory is reading correctly, but not the graphic cards. So we are at the last scene now, and as you can see, the quad core is still over 2000, or occasionally dropping down to less than 2000. But as you can see, the GPU temperature is higher and the fan speed is actually higher as well. And so the score we got is higher FPS here at 116.1, and the score is 29.25. And I can see that the overall FPS in mean and maximum FPS has increased as well. And so we can call this overclock a success. But to test to further stress test your GPU, you should run this benchmark a few more times so that you make sure your GPU is stable. But seeing that we have successfully overclocked our GPU, it means that we can definitely push our GPU further. So let's try with another modest 20 megahertz band on the GPU and click apply, and we're going to the benchmarking again. So we crashed just now and we are come back to this patch, and as you can see, maybe we have reached our power limit, or maybe our core clock is no longer stable when overclocked this much, so we have to reduce it back to 200 here. So maybe you can further push your memory clock. So if it fails, you just need to dial back your overclocking settings, and maybe you want to try and mess around with your power limit. But as I know, this GPU can never hit over 220 overclock, no matter how much power limit I adjust, even though it's max. So I guess you can try to play your games and see there's a little bit of improvement in terms of frame rate per second, which is can be about 5 FPS to 10 FPS depending on the games, but it really lets you extract a bit more performance out of your GPU. So that's it for me today, guys. Thank you for watching. Remember to like and subscribe and share my videos if you find this useful, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye.